I am so pleased to introduce to you our inaugurant, who is a colleague in our College of Graduate Studies. Professor Mpine Makoe, she was promoted to full professorship in 2017, and she currently holds the Commonwealth of Learning Chair in Open Education Practices or Open Education Resources. She's also a National Research Foundation rated scholar and has supervised 10 doctoral students to successful completion. Professor Makoe has published extensively in the area of educational technology, open education, mobile learning, staff development, quality and policy formulation, in open distance e-learning.
On October 14, 2019, the University of South Africa honored the prestigious work and immense contribution made by Professor Mpine Makoe, Chair of the Commonwealth of Learning in Open Educational Resources and Practices. The professor, who has been at the university for more than two decades now, has made a huge contribution to the body of knowledge where educational technology as a tool for access is concerned, and she sets out to do much more.
We started imagining how 2030 will look like, the future will look like. At the rate that technology is developing, it's more likely to even develop further and more. It won't stop. So we need to think about, for a child who will be starting school in 2030, when was that child born? And what is it that he is born with before we can even start developing a curriculum for that child? And now knowledge and content is increasingly made available, and we are not participating in the knowledge generation. I'm talking about the proper one, not the gossip social media stuff, but the proper knowledge generation. And if we are not going to get into the bandwagon, we will continually be disadvantaged.
An occasion filled with happiness and excitement, so Makoe appreciate her husband, children, and those who supported her career.
I also want to thank my dearest partner, my life partner, Ntate Makoe, who has just been such a support for my career. Whenever I wanted to do something, he was there by my side. Even when I did crazy stuff like, now I want to go and do a PhD, he also packed his bag and followed me. So he is a very supportive man. They don't make them like that anymore. And I need to thank my children, my two kids, who had to bear the brunt of a very busy mom who travels all over the place. But, you know, they have a lot of aunties. That's another big advantage. They have a lot of aunties who looked after them when I was not around. My friends who have been pillars of strength through my academic journey, thank you very much. My dearest colleagues, thank you so much. I have so many colleagues that I've worked with, that we have shared, that we have cried together. And thank you for coming to this place. To my students, I see all of them, many of them who graduated, that I held their hand and I shouted at, and they still love me anyway. Some of them are now professors. I produced professors.
Professor Makoe's continued work in and around education has not gone unnoticed. Having worked both locally and internationally, other academics remain pleased with the work she continues to do.
And indeed, the old-fashioned way of pedagogy has had its day. Now even people like us must take citizenship of technology and accept that the world is changing, the world is moving on, and toying, singing and dancing won't stop the industrial revolution.
We know that in the next 5 to 10 years there will be millions of students around the world capable of post-secondary education but will not have access unless we find new ways to promote access to education. And we believe that open education, and in particular open educational resources, will play a significant role in achieving this goal.
distance education and open learning is part of the core, it's the heart of the university. And what she's doing is giving life to that heart so that we are able to open education and open our own hearts and open the doors of learning to those who normally wouldn't be able to access learning.
A proud moment for the professor, but also a time for her family to reflect and share their experiences.
I'm very proud of you, Ma, and you inspire me every single day, and I hope to be as phenomenal as you one day.
Well, you know, it's not easy growing up with such an overachiever as a mother, but, you know, it's more of inspiration than it is as a demotivator. Yeah. So thank you, mother. Thank you.
Very proud of her. Very, very proud and thankful to God that we have her as the mother of the children, as my wife, as our friend, all three of us. We're proud that we are part of her family, she's part of our family.
Those who have been around the prof praised her for the role she plays in their lives, some speaking on the value of education.
There are many people that will tell you that Prof Makoe is their mentor. And we've gone places. We are also, as we are busy dancing, we are imagining that soon we'll also become full professors because she does not take away the ladder when she gets up there. She still pulls us all up.
We are doctors today and we know that we'll be professors one day because UPROF doesn't just tell you, but she leads you and she coaches you so that you reach higher. So we're really, really proud of her. And we know Ubuti, she's going to go even higher. She's a trendsetter.
She's one of the unsung heroines of UNISA because she's quiet and she doesn't blow her own trumpet. I don't think that too many people are aware of the huge amount of work that she's done to advance ODEL on the continent and globally.
You are really an inspiration to us as women, and women at UNISA, we salute you, we honor you, and we look up to you.
She's passionate about their progress, and she's just such a lovely person. The world would be an incredible place if there were more like her.
Tuto ya bereka. Tuto ya bereka, ne ya bereka. Ene bula minya koyo.
Ke ratile dibuo tsene di bua thuto ke lefa la bophelo.
Invited guests continued with the celebration at the Makoe residence.